Hi, everybody. Welcome to Thursday Thoughts at 3 with Jackie and
my girl,
Susan.
How are you guys today? An important topic because we've been working on the show right now. We're working on so many topics we're thinking of for women's empowerment and issues. I thought, what about the men? You know, you get so busy with the Me Too movement, and I'm an equal opportunity employer, for lack of better words. And, you know, the men have lost out. The young boys have lost out.
Yeah.
We've been so busy teaching our girls, along with their feminine qualities and how to be women and nurturers. But now they've stepped up their games in careers and the balancing act and everything we have to do. I wonder how many women and how many fathers have started treating their boys differently. Hi, Tammy. And what do I mean is that I remember when my girls, quick story, when I was raising my girls, granted that was in the 80s, and I had girls, and I was very much, you know, we go to work, we do this, hi, Heimel, and everything probably a lot of us did to bring our girls up many levels to make them feel as important as men. But I watched some of my girlfriends at the time who had boys and girls, and I was truly astounded. As an example, one of them had a boy first. He was king. He was the prince. Then there was the little girl who was 3 years younger. Her name coincidentally happened to be Jackie. And I was stunned. Jackie was 5. Her son was 8. And the son ruled the castle.
Yeah.
He went, I'm hungry. And my friend, whose name was Ellen, turned around and looked at her little 5-year-old Jackie and said, make Nolan a sandwich.
Well, you know, I grew up with Holocaust surviving parents, right? The whole European mentality where the man rules the roost.
Right.
So it's the same thing here. You know, the girls were expected to do for the boys. But I think what this topic comes off of, we just had Domestic Violence Month. The whole, you know, Me Too campaign is strong.
In the workforce, women not getting paid, the sexual harassment.
Right.
Yeah, totally right. But the issue is, and I see it so much in working with marriage mediation, saving the marriages, coaching people one-on-one how to save their marriages. How do we start a new generation of young men? Instead of teaching our little boys when they hit the ages of 3, 4, and 5, when we tell them they
man
shouldn't
up.
Be hugging.
Don't cry. Don't be a sissy.
Don't discuss your feelings. Think about the long-term effects of words like that. Now they get married.
Right.
And they're in a relationship where it's supposed to be equal all around. The woman is helping out in bringing in finances. He's helping out in the home.
But
what's lacking?
He's not allowed to be vulnerable. They can't be vulnerable. They can't be emotional.
He's not
a weak.
It's a weakness. And you know what? So much so that when the wife, I find in a lot of situations, or the woman, even in some, you know, same-sex marriages, whoever takes on each role, I watch and I see the one who takes on more of the male role, when they can't express themselves, and the female is saying, you have to express yourself. I don't know what you're thinking. Communication is critical.
Right.
Let's go. You need to go for therapy. We need to go for help together. They won't even do that because they think it's too feminine.
Right. And I think that's the issue here. Well, we've been trying to make women more masculine. We have neglected to help our boys find their feminine side. Let's just say that.
And we're all born with both sides.
Right. We are. We're both born both sides. But we have more estrogen, progesterone. They have more testosterone. But we all have both hormones.
Oh, yes, we do. We can attest to that as we get older and we lose one and the other. They all go down. But why not let and teach our young boys how to express their feelings the way we have little girls?
And verbally, because there's so many boys that are angry and they become violent in their own ways. They can't express themselves. They express through violence. They express through anger. They express through different ways that are unhealthy, or they internalize it because they don't know how to get it off their chest.
I remember when I was a little girl, I was very athletic. And I mean little, 5, 6, 7. It wasn't okay. I was called a tomboy.
Right.
But it's
and
more...
And that was like a negative connotation.
Very negative.
I thought it was a cool thing.
Well, the truth is, because that's who I was, I thought it was very cool. But it is better for a girl to be called a tomboy than it would be for a boy to be called a sissy.
Yeah, but there's that, you know. That,
you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
I have to tell you, I've seen a lot of young people, next generation, mm-hmm. my children's age, having children,
right.
where I have literally seen husbands and fathers not allow their boys to have kitchens or in their playroom or baby carriages and babies.
Right.
They just don't allow it. They want the hammer.
Right.
They want the basketball
right.
net.
We condition, we teach them what they should be playing with, opposed to allowing, if a child wants to play in the kitchen, a boy wants to play in the kitchen, or a girl wants to play with a hammer, we should allow them to express themselves. And, you know, it's the conditioned learning. It's what we teach our children, like, you can't do this, you can do this. If it's not dangerous.
I know.
I don't know why. And the truth is, though, this generation, I think the next generation, fathers are more involved in
they
the home
are
life.
Involved, yeah. Not even
so
a question.
There is like a little bit, like, from where my father came from to
yes.
what our
and,
sons
and
are
our,
doing.
And our generation.
In our generation. So there's like, it's getting there.
But it's slower for the men.
It's slower for the men. And I think, you know, well, the women's, when we was like pushing the women, the men were just victim of circumstance. Mm-hmm. Like, they had to survive. So they did what they had to do to deal with the women's change.
But you know what? Now they don't have to survive. They bring in their own money. And that is the critical piece in what's going on in long-term relationships or committed or legal and binding relationships. So I would encourage everybody out there with sons and grandsons, don't tell little boys no more hugging other men, that it's not appropriate for them anymore.
Right,
and teach them to verbalize and let them be nurturers. Let them hold that little
right.
baby doll.
But the other thing is also, how many fathers and mothers whose kid comes home and they're crying because the bully in school beat them up,
mm-hmm.
and the parents say, well, go beat them up back, fight
right.
back. So, but it's not the right way to react either.
Correct.
So, you know, because that can go into being a violent person.
It's a bully.
So in the Me Too,
what
you know,
we call it now instead of Me Too, I don't know what to call it with men. I just want to put us all together finally
right.
and call it We Too Movement.
Me Too, because actually with the domestic violence campaign I was on, there was this one gentleman.
Mm-hmm.
He was a domestic violence
Correct.
Survivor. So men were being abused too,
they
but that's
are.
Not even talked about.
No, actually when I was working in the courts in the 90s and I was intake for family court, my first experience with a man who was beaten up by his woman on his wife on
yeah.
a regular basis. And just if in case anybody doesn't know, that is one of the most underreported crimes.
Yeah, there was one like 3 weeks ago. Mm-hmm. Some guy killed himself because his girlfriend was bullying him to do it. So.
And he was taught never to hit a girl, which is very commendable. But why not teach everybody not to hit?
Yeah, and to find the words to use to express, whether it's through, you know, with me, I use the creative arts. If you can't find the words to actually, you know,
mm-hmm.
movement or writing mm-hmm. or drawing, write a letter.
Correct.
It's better.
And when I was coaching with women who came to me with the should I or shouldn't I, hi, everybody, thank you for your wonderful responses today. I would teach them how to speak to their men mm-hmm. and ask for things in kind and loving ways. Mm-hmm. But that's why I'm going into marriage mediation. It's so much better than divorce mediation.
Right.
I want to be able to give the men the same skills.
Right.
It is so important.
Right.
Bring them back as if they were 3 to 5 years old again when they were taught not to.
You know what? We need to create a workshop.
We really do a marriage workshop.
Use the expressive arts as a way of communicating. And
we would do a great workshop. See, brainstorming. This is what happens
anyway.
After the new year. Holiday time is rough. But you know what? Absolutely, a marriage workshop on communication would be so critical.
Yeah.
And we're going to do it.
High five.
Yay. See, guys, thank you. By doing the show, you help us figure out things that, you know, we can do out there. I'm just checking the time. Oh, it's 3:11.
Okay.
We don't like to keep you guys longer than 10 minutes.
This is Susan Greif,
Artman's
Hearts.
Yeah, and if you guys have any thoughts or ideas on anything that we could talk about, help anybody about, please reach us, join us.
Either for this talk or 10-minute talk, or have on our Live with the Vibe show for it's a half-hour talk.
Yeah, and I hope you guys either watched it today at 12, will watch it. The second show went on with Struggle with the Juggle, and it's going to be on the podcast starting Tuesday at noon while you're working.
It's
if you're walking, exercising, if you're in the car, please tune in. It's Struggle with the Juggle. And I guess Jackie Atchison, certified divorce coach, and now marriage, Save the Marriage mediator. Looking forward to seeing you guys again next week. Have a wonderful weekend, and peace out.